can hear you.
It's alright.
It's alright. It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
It's alright.
Just a little talk with Jesus makes it right.
It's alright.
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 It's alright. Just a little talk with Jesus.
Thank you.
Did an excellent job there, sir. Thank you. Go ahead and bless the accidentally dropped offering. Let's start off, continue our service this morning. And Father God, we just thank you for each and every one of us able to be here and praise and worship you and fellowship together this morning. We ask that you would take this offering and bless it and multiply it into our community, around our state, our nation, and our world with the message of salvation through faith in your Son, Jesus. We thank you for being able to celebrate his birth with Christmas, and we thank you for this offering and multiplying it. In Jesus' name, amen. And Ruger and Kimber are going to kick us off with an awesome special here. Get us going.
The cattle are lowing, the baby are
scriptures that talk about coming to God with that faith of a child there. Thank you, kids. We need to come to him with that faith. Do we have any announcements? It's a fun week that we get to celebrate our Lord and Savior's birth. All right. Christmas Eve services, thank you, are 5:30 here at the church at Christmas Eve. So please feel free to come join us, bring all family, friends, whoever you can have come and join you and help prepare to celebrate our Lord and Savior's birth. That's awesome. 5:30 here on Christmas Eve. Any other announcements? Let's go ahead and open up with one more word of prayer then to get us going this morning. Keep us going. Father God, we just thank you so much for being able to be here and give you praise and worship and be able to enjoy the specials from all the kids today and have our faith renewed and inspired by all of our kids singing and giving you the thanks and praise, Father. We ask, please send your Holy Spirit to speak through my mouth to each of our hearts and ears this morning about how we can celebrate the new life that can be in us and around us each day, Father. We thank you for this in Jesus' name. Amen. Hello, everyone. Good morning. So good to see all of your smiling faces. On Facebook, we trust that there's smiling faces out there, too. So anyways, last week we got to talk about that awesome, the inspiration that the Christmas tree can provide for us, right? That green and the new life and that joyful new life, regardless of what the scenario and circumstances around us are. And that's what we get ready to celebrate for Jesus' birth. New life. That's awesome, isn't it? So inspiring to be able to have the Christmas tree, that green, that shot of life, inspire me to remember that each and every day, there's one awesome special day each year we celebrate Jesus' birth, but each and every day I can celebrate that new life alive in me and alive in all the people I see around me that have his life in them. And thinking about new life and the celebrating of new life, think about Joseph and what he had to go through right prior to Jesus being born. You know, the unwed couple, the fiance, who you have not been married and had any marital relations with, all of a sudden pregnant. Joseph had a lot on his plate, didn't he? He had a lot of things to question marks, and he was thinking about quietly stepping back and saying, now I'm bowing out of this one. But Matthew chapter 1, verses 20 to 21 helped inspire him, I think. Or show us his inspiration. As he considered this, an angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream. Joseph, son of David, the angel said, do not be afraid to take Mary as your wife, for the child within her was conceived by the Holy Spirit, and she will have a son, and you are to name him Jesus, for he will save his people from their sins. Matthew 1, verses 20 to 21. Now that last sentence there, that is a reason to celebrate, isn't it? He has saved each of us, all of us, who trust in Jesus from our sins. What he did for us with his life on earth, by being born on Christmas, the day that we celebrate as Christmas, over 2,000 years ago, that started out the wiping away all the wrongs that I could do, or that any of us could ever do. That is a reason to celebrate, in my mind, in my eyes. Let's enjoy this celebration. And that idea of, we talked about in the song this morning, Emmanuel, God with us. Him coming down, God loving each and every one of us. God loves you enough. God loves you enough, and you enough, to come down to earth as a baby child, to be able to have a relationship with you and with me. God loved me enough to want to do this? It makes me kind of take a step back. Whoa. Really? Thank you. Thank you, Father. Thank you, Lord. This is amazing. And salvation. That's just a great reason in my mind also to celebrate and to have that remembrance in my mind, keeping my eyes focused and living each day in light of eternity. Am I doing that each day in preparation for Christmas and celebrating Jesus' birth? And every day in my life, am I living it out in the light of eternity? with the words that I speak, the actions that I do, the way that I interact with people? Am I living it out knowing that Jesus is my Lord and Savior and that eternity is coming? How can I help each and every person around me be prepared for that and be ready? And that is, I think, an awesome gift that God has blessed us with and that can be renewed each day. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 8 to 9, "But let us who live in the light be clear-headed, protected by the armor of faith and love, and wearing as our helmet the confidence of our salvation. For God chose to save us through our Lord Jesus Christ, not to pour out his anger on us." 1 Thessalonians 5, verses 8 to 9. At the end of that first sentence there, the confidence of our salvation. Have I went into the day today? When I wake up each morning, do I go into the day confident, knowing, all right, no matter what's in the rearview mirror, it doesn't matter what's back there. What's back there doesn't have to impact and influence what's going on in front of me. So am I walking forward each day confident, assured, reassured in my head, my heart, my actions, that I have salvation through faith in my Lord Jesus Christ? And I get to celebrate his birth with all of my family and friends and have that, hey, guys, God loves us. We are renewed each day. It's just encouraging. Lamentations chapter 3, verses 22 to 24. "The faithful love of the Lord never ends. His mercies never cease. Great is his faithfulness. His mercies begin afresh each morning. I say to myself, the Lord is my inheritance. Therefore, I will hope in him." Lamentations 3, 22 to 24. His mercies are new and afresh each morning. I love that idea that, like I said, the rearview mirror is wiped away with God. His mercy for you when you woke up this morning, boom, as bright and shiny as the day his son Jesus came to the earth. That's awesome for me. That's just intense and thinking, no matter what happened in the past, God's mercies for me are fresh and renewed and ready to go today. I can walk forward with a clean, clear heart and a clean, clear mind to love on all of my fellow mankind and help them come to know and help them realize that freedom and that release that I have in my spirit. We each have that opportunity to share that love and that joy every day we wake up. And last week we got to talking about the Christmas trees. And this week, thinking about the Christmas trees, a little bunny trail here, quick bunny trail. It's so interesting to me how the Holy Spirit, when he wants to get a point home to us, you know, there's something, you need to learn this, son. You need to learn this, daughter. Something will come up and it will be repetitive until that point is drilled home in my heart and my head and the spirit man. And the idea of the Christmas tree just kept coming up through this whole month, thinking about what will we talk about? What are the lights? What are all the decorations representative of? And it's one aspect, it's celebration. I mean, lights, bright lights, and shiny things, but as I understand all shiny things, that's celebration and happiness and joy. And I get to celebrate the fact that God chose to become human and be born the same way I was born, the same way each and every one of you were born. God chose to come to the earth like that so that he could sense and be a part of everything that I've had to experience, that you've had to experience. Jesus was able to come to earth and be a part of all that and experience those things so that he would understand and be able to say, sister, I love you. I know what you're going through. Thank you for talking with me this morning. Don't worry, brother. I've walked you in your shoes there with that one. Just keep your faith in me and your trust in me. And that he can be that light, that bright light of the Christmas tree, that little lighted star at the top. Those lights just remind me, hey, it's just, for me, it perks you up and awesome. Light just always seems to bring joy and happiness. In John chapter 1, verse 5, Jesus encourages us. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness can never extinguish it. John chapter 1, verse 5. So with Jesus alive and his light alive in our hearts, that can't ever be extinguished. No matter what the world tries to throw at it and tries to cover it up with, that light can be alive in our hearts and in our spirits and lived out in our lives each day, fresh and renewed each morning. In John chapter 8, verse 12, Jesus continues to encourage us. Jesus spoke to the people once more and said, "I am the light of the world. If you follow me, you won't have to walk in darkness, because you will have the light that leads to life." John chapter 8, verse 12. That light, just like on the Christmas trees, that light that draws our eyes to the tree and the renewed life and the green in it. Jesus is the light that can lead and guide me to where I don't ever have to walk in darkness. The darkness that tries to crowd over me at times out in the world, and any one of us, the darkness might try to crowd around us. But no, we have that light alive on us, inside of us. When I'll remember to make sure that I look inside and find that light, make sure the light switch is flipped on. Spend that time with God to keep that light switch flipped on. And the light that leads to life, the joy that can spread from each one of us who has it in our lives, is that joy can spread out into all the lives around us. Just like when we're going through the long checkout aisles, getting ready for Christmas, and one person fires that smile out to the checkout person or to someone else in line that's having to wait patiently, those fun patient building exercises. But someone starts to smile, and pretty soon that smile can be passed down the line. If I have my eyes open, and if each of us have our eyes open, looking for that light and that love, it can be passed around. And pretty soon, that whole situation just has light, life in it. And that light sparkling from the Christmas spirit of love and giving. Have I given things of myself? Have I given my heart, my all into every situation that I've stepped into preparing for Christ's birth, to celebrate Jesus' birth? And am I celebrating it as enthusiastically like the first one celebrated? In Psalm chapter 16, verse 11, "You will show me the way of life, granting me the joy of your presence and the pleasures of living with you forever." Psalm 16, 11. That is an awesome Christmas promise for us from our Heavenly Father right there, to me, in my mind. That way of life, he will guide me and lead me, and each one of us, when we'll remember to slow down, take the time to be still, and remember that he is God, and let him be God in my life, he will show me the way of life. And then that, as he shows me the way of life, the joy, I mean, if we stop and think about that for a second, the joy of living in his presence, and the pleasures of living in his presence forever, kind of makes that place called heaven seem pretty awesome, doesn't it? In my mind, in my eyes, in my thoughts. And then Matthew chapter 5, verses 15 to 16. Jesus continues to encourage us about the lights and light. "No one lights a lamp and then puts it under a basket. Instead, a lamp is placed on a stand where it gives light to everyone in the house. In the same way, let your good deeds shine out for all to see, so that everyone will praise your Heavenly Father." Matthew 5, verses 15 to 16. So have I remembered that today, that any good deeds that I do, if I'm placing it out there to where God is the one who can get the glory, all the good and the love that I show anybody in my life each day brings him all the praise and glory. It also helps other people's eyes and hearts be open to his love coming to them. That's a great thing for me to remember each morning. Sometimes not the easiest, sometimes too. You know, I'll have to raise my hand if I ask, is that ever difficult? Yeah, not the easiest. But his Holy Spirit can allow and guide each one of us to be able to live that out and be that light of love shining to a world that desperately needs a lot of love. The world needs God, it needs love. And each one of us who knows him is that mirror that can reflect that light and that love to a world that needs it. In a bright and continuous celebration, that will help the world see the joy that each one of us has and can have and can live in each day. With the new birth of Christ in me each day and in you each day, Jesus can be born in us and alive in us each day. And we'll remember to call on him and follow his leading and guidance and let his Holy Spirit guide our lives. Matthew chapter 25, verse 40. And the king will say, I tell you the truth. When you did it to one of the least of these, my brothers and sisters, you were doing it to me. Matthew 25, verse 40. That's just such a good encouraging reminder to all those good deeds, to give God thanks and praise. Am I remembering to make sure that I take the time and have open eyes, open ears, and an open heart to be able to see the needs of anyone around me and be able to provide that good deed, whatever the Holy Spirit leads me and shows me is the safe, proper, and right way to do and assist that person? I can know that, okay, I don't have to know if they're a Christian and if they're if they know Jesus as their Lord and Savior. I don't have to know that personally for me to be able to go forward and show them love and say, here, let me help you out with this, please. Do you need a ride? Can I help you out in any way, shape, or form? Save you a little bit of a walk, or would you like a cup of coffee? Whatever I can do to help them out. Let them know that, yes, someone else in the world knows that you're alive and that you have this issue and that you could use some help. I know that's been very meaningful for me when people, you know, thank you to each everyone for the Christmas cards, and all the Christmas wishes and gifts and joyful encouragements. That means so much and is so encouraging to me. So I say thank you to all of you, wherever you're at, for all that encouragement. And that doing it for, that being, doing things for others and giving to others, giving of ourselves to others, that's just that light shining in the world. And Matthew chapter 7, verse 12, Jesus encourages us, do to others whatever you would like them to do to you. This is the essence of all that is taught in the law and the prophets. Matthew 7, verse 12. So have I remembered to do, have I thought about, how do I want you to treat me today? Cindy Lou, how do I want you to treat me today? Have I treated you the way that I want to be treated? Have I treated each and every one of you, my brothers and sisters in the Lord, the way that I hope to be treated by either you or everyone else in the world? And that's a good reminder for me to try to get in a hurry so often. You know how easy it is to get in a hurry? Like, oh, this has to get done. This has to get done. We better not slow down or stop for this, this, or this, because we've got these other five things that need to get done. If I remember to slow down, take time to, you're in control. Here's the reins of the horse. You know, I don't need to guide the horse with the reins of the horse being in control of it. I'll give it to you and then allow him to bring everything in the timely, perfect, might be fast, might be slower order that he knows we can handle, that I can handle, and that will bring him the very most glory. You know, when I'll remember to slow down and be still and know that he is God, he'll bring all those events to come to pass at just the right speed and the right way and the right time. When I don't get in a hurry and a rush and run away and run off the edge of the cliff too fast because I didn't notice that it was there. And the support for other branches in God's family tree. You know, if we consider the green tree as God's family tree, each one of us can be a bright green needle of life and fresh light and life for the tree. How can I support my fellow branches, all of my fellow needles? What are some things I can do? Have I spent time with God, my Heavenly Father, in prayer today and talking to him about any prayer concerns that any one of you or any one of friends or family out in the world have brought to my attention? Have I remembered to slow down and take time to talk to God and intercede? An intercessory prayer, that's called, right? Pastor Bill, Dad? We're getting nods in the back of Facebook, so. Have I taken that time to stop and spend time with God in prayer, lifting up whatever needs I've heard about, whatever needs I know that I have in my own life, and not just needs, but praises? Have I taken time to pray and thank Him for the awesomeness, the blessings that He's bestowed on me? Far too often, it's so easy to get in the, God, I need, God, help, please, please, I need this, I need, I need, I need. Have I remembered to stop and slow down, take time to say, Father God, thank you. Thank you for this sunset. Thank you for this beautiful sunrise. I'm awake this morning for some reason at this time of day. Cool. And I get to see the sunrise. Awesome. I remember to be remembering to be thankful for that. And also supporting all the other branches. Am I sharing the praises about the miracles that God has brought to pass in my life and in each of our lives? Am I open to telling people about the good news and the good things that God is doing for me and sharing that good news so that a world that might feel, you know, Facebook trodden, so to say, kind of bent over, they can have that spark and that light. Hey, God's blessing this person in this way. And that made me think about, oh yeah, I was blessed. And I was happy because of this experience like this the other day. I didn't realize it and notice it at the time, but because I got to hear about how He blessed you in this way, it helped me open my eyes to this blessing yesterday. And 2 weeks ago, a month ago, a year ago, whenever it was. Sharing those praises and those revelations of the miracles God provides each of us each day just helps all of us keep our eyes open and more aware of it, of the miracles and encouragements. Have I been encouraging to other people and help lift them up and help grow them? And, you know, it's easy to get, oh, that person just drives me nuts. Why do I have to deal with so-and-so today? And hug. But have I found something to try to give to God and encourage, or give them an encouragement about God's love for them? Or just be positive and encouraging to people even when they feel like a weight on your shoulders? That happens at times. People can feel like weights on our shoulders, but have I remembered to be encouraging to them? And both in person and if I spend any time online, do we see any encouragements online to everybody and just uplift and joy online, or is a lot of it? I want to make sure that I've got the encouragement factor going on for all those that I deal with in person or online, or going old school with pen and paper or written encouragement. And another fun encouragement idea that I saw in a daily devotional is the idea of they did a Christmas gift for Jesus under their tree every year, his family. And then they thought, okay, well, what can we do with this Christmas gift? So they found somebody that was a needy person, and blessed the gift that was labeled for Jesus under their tree. They gave that person that gift. And that developed and rolled and morphed into a full-time ministry of being able to help more and more needy people that needed the help, truthfully, honestly, needed the help and needed the light and the love of God shining in their life. That idea of one simple gift under a Christmas tree given for Jesus, passed on and multiplied down the pipeline to be able to shed God's love and show God's love to a lot of needy people that desperately needed His love and hurting people that needed His love. And 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 11. So encourage each other and build each other up just as you are already doing. 1 Thessalonians 5:11. And that's good job living where community church, because I believe I'm so grateful to be a part of this church where I think this verse is lived out very well. I believe we do a good job of encouraging each other and building each other up so that even if I'm having a rough day or a rough week or anything, I can come into church on Sunday and I see your smiles, the handshakes, the hug, cheers with a cup of coffee, whatever it is, that spark and that encouragement that, yeah, okay, awesome. Thank you so very much. And I hope that I am that for you too. You know, that we can all just be a family in the body of Christ growing and encouraging each other. And it can help. Each of us can help it be a white and a pure Christmas. You know, the white Christmas idea with the snowflakes and everything on the ground. We could use some snow for the moisture, but it's the weather-wise, it's not breaking my heart personally. It's not necessarily a physically white Christmas outside quite yet. But I can focus on having a pure white Christmas with my thoughts, my words, my actions, and focusing on love for other people. It can be that white, light-filled Christmas for the world around me and for myself, and for my family and friends. With that love for others and making sure I'm thinking right and acting right and speaking right. Right, just being proper and loving and kind. Am I speaking kind, non-judgmental to people about my faith? Just opening the door for them, not kicking them in the shins with my face, with my faith, but softly opening that door. Just consistently having an open door of kind, non-judgmental, hey, this is how God has helped me out. What's your issue? What can he help you out with? What's the need that you might have, friend, family, whoever they happen to be for me? And that can help both me grow in my relationship with God and help them either have a relationship with God and find God through having a relationship with Jesus, or help them grow in the relationship that they do have with God. Either way, it's a win for both parties, both people involved. In 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verses 16 to 18, always be joyful. Never stop praying. Be thankful in all circumstances, for this is God's will for you who belong to Christ Jesus. 1 Thessalonians 5, 16 to 18. Always be joyful. Regardless of what's coming down the pipeline, I can be joyful because guess what? Everybody, one, two, three, one big. Let's all do that together one more time. One, two, three. We all can have a big smile on our face and have joy. We have air in our lungs. We have the ability to have air in our lungs again. We were able to wake up this morning breathing and alive in this world and have God's love in our life. That is a reason to be joyful in my eyes. And as we are always joyful, I can help enable 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 23. Now may the God of peace make you holy in every way, and may your whole spirit and soul and body be kept blameless until our Lord Jesus Christ comes again. 1 Thessalonians 5, verse 23. As we prepare to lift up other people in our prayers and think about our prayer needs to God, my daughter Tyler is going to bless us with something that we can meditate on this week. We can think about who we want to pray for and how we want to pray for them.
Brilliant light the stars in the soon will be coming with fire in his eyes. He will ransom his own. Through clouds he relies, straight into glory, and there he shall reign
that we need to take to our Heavenly Father this morning.
Continue prayers for my sister
in
law, Lori
Christensen,
having surgery.
She's having thyroid surgery. The family of Seymour, young dog.
Yes. Seymour Young Dog's family, all his family and friends.
Remember Bob and Missy, they have begun their journey to Paraguay.
Bob and Missy on their journey to Paraguay and their new mission to Paraguay. We'll definitely remember them in our prayers each day. Prayers and thoughts and sending the love to them down there that they can send to an area that desperately needs God's love. Yep.
Dave and Cheryl Houck, home
of COVID, so. Okay, Dave and Cheryl Houck. Cheryl Houck. Recovery from COVID.
Are those traveling this week for Christmas?
Yes. Safety and wisdom and guidance for everyone out on the road traveling to celebrate Jesus' birth. Family and friends and wherever they're celebrating.
There has been a lot of suicide in this area that I've heard of. One of my friends
the young people and the suicide rate in our area. We can keep need to lift up all the hearts and minds of the young people that they can come to know about God and come to know about Jesus and the love that God has for them, so that they can know that shutting the light switch off by their own hand is not the right path. In any format that they would, if the family and friends could have the patience and the wisdom to help love them, their family and their friend, to find that there is freedom, that there can be freedom. It's all a list of people and things to lift up in intercessory prayer to our Heavenly Father. So let's take these to God our Father this morning. And Father God, we just thank you that we can get together and learn from your word together and grow in our relationship with you and to lift other people up and bring them before you and bring their needs before you, Father. We just ask that your hand of healing and wisdom and guidance would be over Lori Christensen and over the surgeons, the doctors. Please guide their hands to help her body be set free from the cancer that is bothering her with the thyroid situation. And Father, we also ask that your hand of healing and wellness would flood over Dave and Cheryl Houck, that their bodies would be restored from COVID. And Father, we lift up the Seymour Young Dog family and pray that your spirit of peace and comfort would flood over them as they say, have to say see you later to Seymour right now. And Father, we lift up Bob and Missy and just ask for your hand of wisdom and blessing and guidance for them as they make their way to Paraguay to live out the gospel and take the mission that you've called them to down there to pass. We thank you for that and being with them. And Father, we ask for wisdom and safety and guidance for everyone traveling all over the Christmas holiday to be with their family and friends around the world, wherever they're at. Just ask for safety and wisdom for each person traveling. And Father, we just ask for your wisdom and peace and comfort for all of the youth of our area, that the doors of suicide that they look at, those doors would be closed and that your light of love would shine into all of the hearts and minds and lives of the young people around our whole area and around our nation and our world, but especially in our area, Father. We ask for your spirit of love and peace and wisdom and guidance for the youth of our area. And also we lift up any and all family and friends of anyone who is dealing with an addiction of any kind. We just ask for patience and wisdom and love and guidance for their family and friends, that the family and friends can be loving and guiding, loving and patient and caring for the person that is dealing with that addiction, and just be the light of consistent love there for them so that they can come to know that there is freedom from those addictions and that they can find the freedom and that they can want to find that freedom from that addiction. Father, we just thank you for all of these prayers coming to pass in your perfect way and in your perfect time. We just lift all these things up in Jesus' name with the prayer that he taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Now the Lord bless you and keep you. The Lord make his face shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his face toward you and give you peace. And Merry Christmas.
Christmas.